Hello, my name is Amy Ecker and welcome to my channel. Today I'm doing an all-day wear test on this foundation by Natasha, Denona. And this is in the color 40 Natural Light. I probably picked up this color and it's a little bit too dark for my skin tone, but I made it work. So we are going to see how this applies and then what it looks like by end of day. So if you want to see how this Natasha Denona foundation does for me on a combo oily skin, stay tuned. All right, let's see how this Natasha Denona Foundation X Full Coverage Fruit Complex works. And this one is in number 40 and it's called Natural Light. All right, so that's already covered up that dark spot, so that's pretty cool. As far as the primer, I've used Scandinavia's spray primer, so that's all I'm using under the as my primer. All right, so initial impressions. My initial impression is it looks like it went on really well. So I used two pumps for each side of the face and about a pump for my neck. So roughly five pumps. They didn't come out super, like a ton in the pump, so wasn't bad there. But yeah, I think I really like this overall first coverage. So we're gonna see how this lasts through the day. And that little brush, I mean, it looks flawless. Like, I don't have any brush streaks. I don't have, it just covered really nice. So I'm kind of excited about this already. Whoop. Let's see how it does today. All right, so it's end of work day. How did the Natasha Denona foundation hold up? I just love saying her name, Natasha Denona. It just kind of rolls off the tongue. Sounds kind of exotic. Natasha, my name is Natasha Denona. But all seriousness, it is end of work day and let's give a review. So I have not touched up during the day and it has been a swampy mess. So overall, I'm pretty impressed with how the foundation held up during the day. It's not overly oily, which is super nice. I did lose some of the foundation around my nose for my glasses that I wore. But other than that, everything is holding up really, really well. So as long as I hadn't wore glasses or took them on and off, I don't think I would have seen that smudge. The other thing is my nose always has a really difficult time, my nose and my chin, keeping the foundation on. So other than where my glasses are, it really hasn't separated bad. Just a tiny bit of separation on my nose. But my chin has done well overall, and I did catch myself leaning on my chin throughout the day, so I'm super, super impressed with how well that held up with me leaning my chin on my hands. So how do I feel about this foundation? I feel that I love it. So this foundation has a slightly more dewy look, but I would put this in the same category as the Marc Jacobs. So I love both of those, or I love Marc Jacobs as far as the foundation goes, and it's a very matte look, which I figure during summer for me, being combo oily, more on the oily side, less on the combo, that the Marc Jacobs would do very well on my skin. However, I do like how this foundation sits on my skin. I like how it held up throughout the day. And like I said, the heat and the moisture, it's been a swampy mess here in Texas. So I really am impressed with this foundation. It is on the pricey side, so y'all get ready to pull out your wallet. But when you get a foundation that works so well, it's hard not to spend the money for it. And again, all I used as far as a primer and a setting spray was one of each from Scandinavia. So I didn't even use some of my special primers. Not that I don't love my Skindinavia, because I do, but there's a couple primers that I really like how they make the foundation look. So overall, I am super pumped, super impressed about this Natasha Denona foundation. And so that actually is a winner for me, and I will most likely be checking out some of her other products to see, are they as nice as the foundation? So if a foundation can hook me, then I typically will try some of the other products. So Natasha, way to go. This is a great one. Thank you so, so much. Now I just gotta find one that's a closer to my skin color. So we'll see how that goes, but it's a great foundation. If any of you have tried this foundation, whether it's my dry skin girls or my combination or oily girls, please put your comments below. I'd really like to hear, how does this foundation work on you? And we will chat soon. Thank you again. Thank you so much for watching my video today on this all-day wear test with the Natasha Denona foundation. Again, this is in the color 40, Natural Light. So if you did like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing or refer me to a friend. And if you have any comments on this foundation, whether you are a combo, an oily, or a dry kind of skin, I would love to hear your comments below and tell me, how did you think this foundation worked for you? As always, we have a choice, so choose to make it a beautiful day. Until next time.